Hey there, I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and today we're going to talk about what is active insulin on board, or IOB, and how to calculate it. IOB, active insulin on board, refers to how much of your rapid acting insulin is left in your system. So your rapid acting insulin is your Humalog, your Novolog, your Fiasp, and it's those types of insulin that we use to quickly lower our blood sugars, for example, if we eat or if we want to do corrections. That type of insulin, the way that it works is that when you inject it, so you inject it in fatty tissue, when you inject it, it will generally enter the bloodstream in about 10 to 15 minutes, but won't really start to work yet. It will be at its peak. So it'll be working the best after about an hour, hour and a half, and it will last in your system for 3 to 5 hours. It's a wide range because it depends very much on the person. I usually assume 4 hours because that seems to be fairly accurate for me, for most people I know, and it's the easiest for calculating. Knowing your IOB is really important for two things. It's important for dosing, and it's important for knowing if you have too much insulin on board for a given activity. So let's talk about dosing first. So a lot of us, when we are diagnosed, are told not to stack insulin. Stack insulin means taking a lot of doses relatively close to each other, for example, within that 4 hour time frame that insulin generally lasts. The thing is, if you know your IOB, stacking is not necessarily an issue because you'll know when you're overstacking. So it can be a great tool, again, in assessing, should I add more insulin or should I not? The other thing I mentioned was for activity. One of the things that I think is most overlooked when we talk about diabetes management is IOB. Simply because if you go low during an activity, such as let's say go for a walk or go exercise, if you go low, it's because you have too much IOB. That's the only reason why you're going low. If you had the adequate, the right amount of IOB for you for that given activity, you wouldn't go low. So, that being said, if you understand how much IOB is right for you for different types of activities, you can significantly reduce the amount of low blood sugars that you have. There are different ways to finding out what your IOB is at any given time. If you use an insulin pump, on their screen, it will tell you your IOB. So simply say IOB. Of insulin on board, it'll be right there on your screen. What you need to be aware of though is your pump will only calculate IOB from your corrections and your mealtime boluses. That means none of all of that rapid acting insulin that's actually dripping in as basal insulin is included in that. I'll tell you how to calculate it in a second, but something to be aware of. If you use multiple daily injections, MDI, like I do, there are a few different ways to keep track of IOB. One could be, if you're here in the US, there's such a thing as a smart pen. It's called an InPen, I-N-P-E-N. So one I currently use, that will automatically keep track of your IOB as all your doses are Bluetooth to an app. If you don't have that, there are some different apps available. The US does not have any FDA approved apps. However, I have been using one for years called Rapid Calc, R-A-P-I-D-C-A-L-C. I will add a link to a video I did on that specific app down in the description field. So those are sort of the way you can use technology to keep track of IOB. If you're in Europe, there are some different apps as well. I believe My Sugar can also keep track of IOB, and there are some meters that can as well. But if you don't have access to any of that technology, you will have to calculate your IOB yourself. Same thing, as I said, if you're on an insulin pump and you actually want to know what your true IOB is or your IOB for your basal, you need to calculate it yourself. So let me show you how to do that, but it's actually fairly simple. Okay, let's calculate your IOB. So first, let's assume that you're on a pump. So that means we're calculating your basal IOB. Let's assume 1 unit an hour. Just because that's easiest. So we assume, again, an insulin duration of 4 hours. So that means you get 1 unit every hour. Okay? So what we assume then is that this will leave your body sort of at the same pace. So that means all the insulin that you got within the last hour, we assumed 100% of that is left. what you got the hour before, we assume 75% of that is left. You got before, 2 hours before, would be 50% left. And then what you got before that would be 25% left. Okay, so basically you just multiply them all. And if you run those numbers, what you'll see is that your IOB is 12.5 at any given time. Again, assuming that you get 1 unit an hour. I mean, we can even put in the one for the hour before, but you'd have 0% left of that, so it'd still be 2.5. Most people don't have the same basal rate going 24/7 if they're an insulin pump. Let's just choose a number. Let's say instead that you're doing 2 units here instead of 1. Run the numbers again, you'd see that your IOB would be 3. Okay, so that's how you do that, assuming again a 4-hour insulin duration time. If you are on MDI, multiple daily injections like I am, it's a little different because you don't need to do, you know, all the calculations. You just need to look at the individual doses. So let's make an example where we say we take 4 units 2 hours ago for lunch. Okay, so that means that now we assume that 50% of that is left. That means your IOB is 2. Why can this be helpful? Well, this can be helpful. Let's say that, again, you ate 2 hours ago and you're at 200 milligrams per deciliter. Let's say that. So it's just over 10. Then you need to think about, well, those 2 units you have left, will those 2 units reduce your glucose down into the level that you wanted to? For a lot of people, it probably would. So this would be one of the situations where you want to think about what is your IOB and not do any unnecessary stacking, because then you might end up going low. But this calculation, it's the same one that the pumps do. It's the same one that the smart pens do in order to calculate your IOB. This is just if you want to do it manually.
As you see, that's actually a fairly simple calculation. Most of us would rather not have to do that manually, or, you know, it's one thing is you need to keep track of all your doses in the last 4 hours. Sometimes we do end up taking more than 1 or 2, and it's just doing math. So I would recommend that if you do not have an insulin pump, if you do not have a smart pen, to invest in something like, for example, RapidCalc that I mentioned before, or another tool. But back to why is IOB important? I do really think it's one of the most overlooked components of diabetes management, because your IOB is literally the reason why you will go low during a certain activity if you have too much IOB. Same thing, it'd be why you go high for another. Let's say that you like to do resistance training. Resistance training can actually make blood sugars go up during the activity, come down later. So it's so important that you have enough IOB on board during, so that you don't see a sharp increase, but you don't see a sharp decline after. Same thing with aerobic activity, that will, for a lot of people, make our blood sugars drop. So if you have too much IOB, you will drop too much. So it's a critical component to managing your diabetes levels. I hope this video made sense to you. I hope it was helpful. Thank you so much for watching.